Hello my lovely friends, it's Yulia here. In my previous videos I've talked about the benefits of drinking loose leaf tea. But to get those benefits you need to know how to brew your loose leaf tea properly. So in this video I'll show you the simplest way to steep your loose leaf tea to get the finest flavor out of it. This draws on the principles of brewing related to meditation and the Chinese Zen monks. The Buddhist monks were very closely knit with the evolution, production and the brewing ritual of the finest loose leaf teas, so if anyone knows how to brew your loose leaf tea properly, it would be them. The traditional Zen tea ceremony is very complex though, so to avoid overwhelm, today I'll only show you the three key steps to brewing. If you master these three key steps, you'll be very close to steeping like a proper Zen tea pro, so let's begin. The first step is getting the correct leaf to water ratio. The exact amount of leaf recommended really depends on your tea, as there are thousands of varieties of loose leaf tea, so in order to help you guys, I've created a PDF for you to refer to download. But for simplicity, I'd recommend starting with around 3.5 grams of leaf, which is around a large heaped tablespoon of tea, per 100 milliliters of water, which is around a third of a cup. The second step is to choose the correct water temperature. Once again, the exact water temperature depends on your tea and can be found in my guide. But for simplicity, green teas require the lowest water temperature. I like to have mine at no higher than 70 degrees Celsius. Yellow and white teas can take a higher temperature of 80 degrees Celsius, whilst black teas, oolongs and pu'ers can be brewed at the highest temperature of 90 degrees or even higher. If you don't have a temperature kettle, then I will create another video for you explaining how to get the correct water temperature without having to measure it. And the third step is the steeping time. Yes, you've guessed it, this also depends on your tea, but to start with, I will brew the first infusion for about 15 seconds and then increase the steeping time by 3 seconds with each subsequent brew. Loose leaf teas can and should be re-steeped. I generally steep my green tea at least 3 times, whilst black teas, white teas, oolongs and pu'ers can be re-steeped even more. There are some black teas which I love to re-steep up to 10 or 15 times. Each subsequent steeping releases different aromatic compounds, meaning that your loose leaf tea might taste very different with each brew. Although the right brewing technique and a good loose leaf tea aren't necessary, having these will just help you create a better tasting tea. A good tasting tea, which also looks beautiful, and having a ritual to follow, will just help you be in the moment and be more present and mindful as you appreciate the beauty of the tea and its subtle, complex flavors. This helps your body and soul unwind, slow down, and combats the stresses of life through a ritual. If you do want to learn how to become immune to the stresses of life, to slow down and unwind whenever you need to, using the ritual of loose leaf tea as a tool for this, then please do feel free to download my guide in the description link below. But remember though, that to get the most benefit out of your tea, the key is not just in the technique, but also in making the ritual your own and in being in the moments with your body, your soul and the process. I really hope you found this video helpful. If you like this video, hit the like button below, share it with your friends, and be sure to subscribe. Alright, that's all for today. Happy brewing! Delicious with Yulia is signing off, and I'll see you again next week. Ciao!